So we'll solve one or two worksheets also on data handling, so you can have a quick revision on what you all have learned. Okay, so what is data handling? It is nothing but it's a means to gather and record information and then presenting it in a way that is meaningful to others. So when you want some information, you gather the information, correct? Then when you present it in a meaningful way, means in the form of graphs, okay, or tables, then that is called as presenting the data in a meaningful way. Okay, so this is data handling. Alright, so it is nothing but the means gathering and recording information and then presenting it in a way which is meaningful to others. Okay, then we saw what are pictograph. So pictograph is a tool which is used to represent numbers or data using pictures. Okay, so pictographs helps you to represent numbers or any kind of information or data using pictures. Okay, so this is one example of a pictograph. So this is how a pictograph will look. So here in the first column of the table, they've given you different flavors of ice cream, and here in the second, they've shown you pictures of ice cream telling how many people like which flavor. So vanilla, 3 people like vanilla flavor. Chocolate, 7 people like chocolate. Strawberry, 5 people like chocolate. Sorry, strawberry, 4 of them like pineapple and 1 likes peach. Correct? So this is how a pictograph looks like. Pictograph is also called as a pictogram. Okay, so based on a given pictograph, they'll ask you questions and you have to answer the questions. Okay, so here this shows the number of boys and girls in a class. And here they have given you a key. What does this key state? This one boy, one picture of a boy represents 5 boys. So if you want to count the total number of boys in the class, you have to count it as 5 plus 5 plus 5. That is 15. Or there are 3 boys here and one boy shows 5 boys, right? So 5 into 3 if you do 15. Okay, same way for girls. So one picture of girls stands for 5 girls. So number of girls will be 5 into 3, 15. So total number of boys and girls in class is 15 plus 15, 30. So this way you have to answer questions given. So we solved this well last time, right? So here we saw there are a number of vegetables and we answered the questions on this. So how many tomatoes are there? How many tomatoes are shown here? 1, 2, 3, 4. So there are 4 tomatoes. Then which kind of vegetable is maximum in number? Which do you think has maximum? You have to count. So we have potato which has maximum with 7. Okay, so which kind of vegetable is minimum in number? So which is a less number? Capsicum, correct? So 1, 2, 3. And then what is the total number of vegetables? So you have to count all the vegetables together to see what is the total number. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24 and 25. Okay, so there are total 25 vegetables. Or what you can do, you can add the number of tomatoes, 4 plus number of capsicum, 3 plus carrot, 6. Mushroom plus 5 and potato plus 7. So 4 plus 3 plus 6 plus 5 plus 7 gives you 25, which is the total number of vegetables. Okay, then we saw another pictogram here. They're telling one tree represent 10 trees. That is, one picture of a tree shows 10 trees. Okay, so here they've given you names and number of trees. So let's form a few questions. Now I'll ask you, how many apples are there? Apple trees are there. How many apple trees are there here? 1, 2, 3. And as we know, each one represents 10 trees. So that will be 10 into 3, 30. So apple trees are 30 in number. Then I'll ask you, how many guava and pear trees are there together in total? Okay, how many guava and pear trees are there in total? So we have, first let's count the trees, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 guava trees, and pear we have 2, that is 5 plus 2, 7, and 7 into 10 is 70. So we have 70 guava and pear trees together. Okay, then how many peach trees are there? So how many peach trees are there? 1, 2, 3, 4 into 10, 40. There are 40 peach trees. Now if you have to find the total number of trees, how will you find? So we'll add the number of apple trees. We found the number of apple trees. It was 30, correct? Then plus number of peach trees, it was 40. So 30 plus 40, then we have guava and pear together, we calculated, which is 70, correct? So 40 plus 30 plus 70, that is 140, okay? So we have 140 trees together. So this is basically how you read a pictogram. So let's solve a few questions on that. Okay, so here is a worksheet on pictogram. So let's read the question that they've told. So it was a lovely Sunday afternoon. Tiffany and her friends Rick, Mindy and Matt spent the day on the beach. So Tiffany and her three friends Rick, Mindy and Matt spent the day on the beach on a Sunday. So they built sand castles and connected seashells. Okay, the pictograph below shows the number of seashells collected by each person. Use the pictograph to answer the questions. Okay, here the pictograph, and here they have given the name of all of them. Okay, that's Tiffany, Rick, Mindy and Matt. And here they have given you the number of seashells, correct? So and how many each have collected. So here is the key. One picture of a seashell represent 4. Okay, so let's answer these questions. How many seashells did Rick collect? So Rick is here. Now how many did he collect? We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But we know that one picture represent 4 seashells, correct? So we will have 5 into 4, 20. So Rick collected 20 seashells. Okay, next question. Who collected less than 20 seashells? So for that you have to look overall how many they have collected. Okay. So who collected less than 20 seashells? Now we know that Rick has collected 20. So it is not less than 20, it is exactly 20. Now let's look at others. So Tiffany, how many has she collected? She has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 6 into 4 is how much? It is 24, so it is more than 20. Then Mindy. Mindy has how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 7 into 4, 28. So even she has more than 20 seashells. Then last, Matt. 1, 2, 3. How much is 3 into 4? 3, 4 is 12. So who collected less than 20 seashells? It is Matt. Okay. So first answer is 20. The second one is Matt. Then, how many seashells did they collect all together? So, how many did Tiffany collect? She has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 into 4, 24, correct? Then, Rick, we know that he has collected 20. Then, Mindy has how many? 7 into 4, 28. So, she's collected 28. And what about Matt? Matt has how many? He has 3 into 4, 12. So, how much is the total here? 24 plus 20. Plus 28 plus 12. So calculate the answer here. What will you all get? So all of them together have collected 84 seashells. Okay. 24 plus 20 plus 28 plus 12 is 84. So together they have 84 seashells. Then how many more seashells did Mindy collect than Matt? So how many Mindy has? Mindy has 28 and Matt has how many? Matt has 12. So to see how many Mindy collected more than Matt, what you will do? We will do 28 minus 12, which is 16. Okay, so she has 16 more than Matt. Then how many seashells did Tiffany and Rick collect altogether? So how many did Tiffany collect? She collected 24 and Rick collected how many? He collected 20. So together they collected 40. 4 seashells. Alright, so this is how you read a pictograph. So this was one worksheet. Now what we'll do is, we'll solve a few questions based on what we did in your textbook and then we'll move on to another worksheet. Okay, so here first they have asked count the number of letters in each of the following and fill in the boxes. So Bugs Bunny, how many letters does Bugs Bunny have? We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Correct? Bugs Bunny has 9 letters. Then Mickey Mouse, how many letters does Mickey Mouse have? He has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Mickey Mouse has 11 letters. Then Donald Duck, how many letters does Donald Duck have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So Donald Duck has 10 letters. Then what about Tom and Jerry? Tom and Jerry, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Tom and Jerry has 11 letters. Okay, so let's see if our answers are correct. So all our answers are right. Correct? So now what we'll do? We'll move on to the next one. So here they're told this pictograph shows how many students had ice cream, how many had fruit, and how many had fruit juice. Study the pictograph and fill in the boxes with the correct numeral. So this is the pictograph and one image of a boy stands for one student. So how many students had ice cream? Let's count. So this is where it shows ice cream. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Correct. So 6 students had ice cream. The number of students who had fruit salad. Fruit salad is over here. How many had fruit salad? 1, 2, 3. 3 students had fruit salad. So we'll write 3 here. Correct? See, our answers are right. Correct. So ice cream, 6 students had, and fruit salad, 3 students had. Okay, then next question. In this pictograph tells how many storybooks each child has. Study the pictograph and fill in the boxes with the correct numeral. So this is the pictograph and each book shows stands for 2 storybooks. Right, so Amar has Somini, Bal and Chetan. So let's see what are the question. Who has the least number of storybooks? Who has the least number? And if you see Amar has 1, 2. So that is 2 into 1 book stands for 2 storybooks. We know that. So 2 plus 2, 4. Amar has 4. Then Chetan has 6. So Amar is the least one. So who has the least number of storybooks? It is Amar. Okay, and how many storybooks does Bal have? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So pictures are 5. So and each book stands for 2 storybooks. So 5 into 2, 10. So he has 10 storybooks. Okay, so least number of storybooks is Amar. And how many books does Bal have? He has 10 books. Now, how many books does Chetan have? He has 1, 2, 3 into 2, 6 books. Okay. Then, pictograph shows how many vehicles passed a particular spot on a road in 10 minutes. So, study the pictograph and fill in the boxes with the correct answer. So, cars, buses, and bicycles. Each picture of a car stands for 2 cars. This shows 2 buses, and this one bicycle stands for 2 bicycles. So, how many cars pass the spot? How many cars? So, we have 3 here. 1, 2, 3 into 2 will be how many? It will be 6. So, 6 cars pass the spot. And how many bicycles? We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, that is 2 into 5. 10 bicycles. Then buses 1, 2, 3. So, sorry, the next question is how many vehicles passed by? So, total number of vehicles. So, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 11 into 2 is how much? It is 22. So, 22 bicycles. Okay, so that's not 22. Let's check again. Okay, so we have 6 cars, then we have 6 buses. And we have 10 bicycles, correct? So that is 20. Okay, it is 20. The answer is 20. So this is how you do pictograph. So let's do revision using one more worksheets and then we can finish this class. Okay. So here we have the pictograph represents number of toys owned by 5 students. See the picture, see the pictograph to answer this question. How many toys does Saroj have? Okay, so this one picture of this toy represents 10 toys. They are asking how many toys does Saroj have? Well, Saroj is here. So she has 1, 2, 3, that is 3 into 10, 30 toys. So answer here is 30. So B, 30. Okay, so Saroj has 30 toys. Then this pictograph shows the number of students in each class. See the pictograph to answer this question. How many students are there all together? Okay, so we'll do this one by one. So first of all, in grade 1, how many students are there? And one picture of the students represents 10 students. Okay, so in grade 1, how many students are there now? We have 1, 2, 3, so that is 3 into 10, 30. So grade 1 has 30 students. Then what about grade 2? Grade 2 has 1, 2, 3, 4 into 10, 40 students. Then grade 3 has how many? Grade 3 has 5 into 10, 50. And grade 4 has 2 into 10, 20 students. So what will be the total number of students? It will be 30 plus 40 plus 50 plus 20. That is 70, 70 plus 50, 120, and 120 plus 20, 140. Okay, so the total number of students altogether are 140. Alright, then. Okay, we have done this right with trees, so we'll do it once again. The pictograph shows the number of different trees in a farm. See the pictograph to answer this questions. How many peach trees are there in the farm? So one tree represent 10 trees. So peach trees. So we have apple, peach, guava and pear. So they have asked how many peach trees are there in the farm. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 into 10, 40. So peach trees are 40. Okay, then the pictograph represents the number of toys owned by 5 students. So this is the same pictograph as the question 1. See the pictograph to answer this question. How many more toys does Lily have than Atul does? Okay, so how many toys does Lily have? Lily has 4 into 10, 40 toys, correct? So Lily, see here, 1, 2, 3, 4. And each represents 10 toys, so 4 into 10, 40. And how many toys does Atul have? Atul has 20 toys. So how many toys does Lily have more than Atul? It will be 40 minus 20, which is equal to 20. So here the answer is 20. That is option D. Then, last question. This pictograph shows the number of different fruit trees in a farm. So how many more guava trees are there than apple trees? Okay, so how many guava trees are there? We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 into 10, 50 guava trees. And how many apple trees are there? Apple trees are 3 into 10, 30. So how many more guava trees are there than apple? That will be 50 minus 30 equals to 20. Okay, so there are 20 guava trees more than apple trees. So this is a small worksheet based on pictograph or data handling. Okay, so this was a quick revision on the last chapter, that was data handling. Alright, so we'll continue further in the next class. Thank you, students.